Have you come here to congratulate us or humiliate us?
Please try to understand, Mr. Khajan Singh. It is too early for Anandi to get married. Let her study and then you can get her married at the right age. Your daughter is a very bright student.
What difference will it make whether she studies or not? She is a girl, she will be doing household work in future.
Education will help her even in that.
But girls don't need education to learn all this. And the rest will be taught by her mother-in-law.
Anandi is just 8 years old. It won't be too late even if you get her married after 10 years.
So you are telling me that I should let go such a good prospect?
So go and talk to them. If they really like Anandi, they will wait for their wedding. Otherwise...
Yes, why not? Ma'am, are you out of your mind? You think they will wait for Anandi's studies to complete and then they will plan the wedding? Ma'am, it will be folly to let such a good prospect go away. I am not that foolish.
How can you be so sure that the alliance is good? If he grows up to become a thief, dacoit or a criminal, then will you bring Anandi back home?
Look, madam, we respect you and all that. But don't cross your limits. Don't spoil our mood by talking this nonsense.
You are a woman. You understand a woman's physical and emotional needs. Do you really believe that Anandi is ready for marriage? Does Anandi know what a marriage really means? Ask her once at least that apart from new clothes and wedding feast, what does she know about marriage?
Enough, ma'am. Enough of it. Marriage and age has no relation. I was 6 when I got married and I am very happy. I took care of everything, my family and also raised kids. And when a girl gets married, she becomes responsible and transforms into a woman. And moreover, I don't want my daughter to be educated. She might end up being a spinster like you. We are just getting her marriage ceremony done. Her farewell will take place after a few years.
That is what I'm trying to explain you. You don't need to treat Anandi like a burden to yourself at all. There is no need for you to get rid of her. After she gets married, she will be answerable to her in-laws. After that, they will be the ones deciding for her. Think about Anandi's future.
We have decided this after a lot of thought.
Child marriage. It is a crime according to the law, don't you know? You have no idea. You might have to face very bad consequences for that. The police can come and arrest you.
Okay. You're threatening us of police? Go! Hurry up, go and call! Whoever you want to, call anyone you want to! I am not afraid of anyone. On this Akshaya Tritiya, I'll get my daughter married.
Mr. Khajan Singh, please try to understand. Don't ruin your daughter's life, please.
She is my daughter, and I have every right to decide about her life. You better stay out of this. Don't create a ruckus in my house. Keep your advice with you and get out of my house.
So you won't listen to me. All right. I'll see to it that this marriage does not take place.
She should not create any trouble in our daughter's wedding.
If she tries to create any trouble, then I'll have to find a solution for her.
Ma'am, when I see you teaching, I also feel like teaching others. Ma'am! looking for you in the entire village and I found you here. You came to know, ma'am, that I'm getting married on this Akshaya Tritiya. I heard my dad telling mom that sweets will be brought from Jodhpur. They will be wonderful sweets. You will enjoy a lot at my wedding.
That's why you didn't come to school today.
I wanted to come to school, I swear. As usual, I woke up and was ready for the school. But mom refused me to go there. And even dad told me that after marriage, one never goes to school. I have to start learning household work. Now that only will be my education. Even Fuli told me that married girls never go to school, isn't it?
Then on Teacher's Day, how will you become a teacher like me?
Oh yes! I completely forgot that. Now what? Let's do one thing. You tell me in advance what I need to teach the students. I have got books with me. I will prepare the topics and teach it quietly. Mom and Dad won't even come to know. And after teaching, I will come back home. All right? But then, where will I wear the sari? Oh my God, that's a big problem now.
So you will come only on that day? Won't you miss school at all after that?
No, I will.
She won't miss her school at all. You may leave now. Don't instigate my daughter, or else you will have to pay for it. Let's go.
But Dad, I will miss my school very much.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Congratulations. You might have got the good news. Your student, our Khajan Singh's daughter, Anandi's marriage has been finalized. This is called good luck, being at the right place at the right time. Khajan Singh is very fortunate that his daughter has got such a good house. The boy belongs to a very affluent family. I know it because I deliver letters there as well. They always give me big tips during festive seasons. They own many farms. They also have their own wells. And most importantly, their son is the sole heir. Khajan Singh's daughter is very lucky. I think I should go to his place and congratulate him. You should come with me.
Why do you seem to be so happy about it, Purushottam?
Oh, come on, why shouldn't I? Ma'am, the wedding is taking place in our village. Wouldn't I be happy? We all belong to the same village. A family goes back a long way. Anandi is like a daughter to me.
Okay, so you're happy to sacrifice your second daughter's life.
Ma'am, what are you talking about, ma'am?
Why? Am I saying something wrong? You got your elder daughter married at a tender age of 13, did you forget? At the age of 14, she became pregnant. Neither did she survive, nor her child. And this didn't happen too long ago, Purushottam. Still, you are happy to hear this news? Do something to stop it. This is not right at all.
It is impossible to stop this, ma'am. Even if you raise a little voice, you will be exiled and they will insult you and throw you out of the village.
This fear of society will never do us any good. What about our daughters' lives and their dreams? Don't they mean anything to you? Purushottam, your silence will just worsen the problems.
Respected ma'am, it is impossible to eradicate this practice. To get rid of it is not under our control. When evil stays for a long time, it becomes a custom and then a power of the society. Fighting against it is like fighting against the society. You don't challenge a crocodile in water. So just forget about fighting against it, ma'am. All right then, I should go meet Khajan Singh.
God, girls, are your hands tied or what? There is so much work to do and you girls don't like to work at all. Do you want to spoil a village's reputation or what?
But then Bhavri, what do? We don't have the energy that you seem to have.
Oh my dear silly girl, if I didn't have the energy that you talk about, half of the people around here would have been unmarried. They would have been wandering around and doing nothing. All of you are so busy with household chores. Had it not been for me, none of your children would have been ever married. Yes. Well, hurry up. The food will get burnt.
Aunt Bhavri.
Yes?
You know that Champa, she was saying that all these sweets are being prepared for the guests. She said that I won't get anything. She's lying, isn't it?
Girl, keep quiet. You talk too much. You will spoil our village's reputation at your in-laws' place.
Oh my, my. This is such a special and big event in her life. And you are scolding her? Come on, give some sweets to Anandi.
How can I give it right now? First, we have to offer it to God.
Then give some separate for the offerings. Dear, come here. I will give it to you. Take this. Go on. Eat. Come. She is so innocent. She is behaving like she is just another guest.
Aunt, should I help you?
Rani, what are you doing here?
Well, Anandi forced me, that's why.
Are you out of your mind? Anandi is just a kid, but you are grown up. Don't you have any sense? Do you want to pass on your bad luck to her and spoil this auspicious deed? Go away from here. Go!
But Krishna, she could have stayed here. But yes, she's ill-fated.
You know, in the future, if something wrong happens with Anandi, then I will be held responsible for her actions, right? As such, she's a social butterfly. She doesn't like to stay inside the house. She just likes to gossip and roam around in the village all day long. That's it. The entire day, I have to do the work. Do you want to pass on your bad luck to her and spoil this auspicious deed? Go away from here.
But Krishna, she could have stayed here. But yes, she's ill-fated.
See how unfortunate I am to get a daughter-in-law like her. She thinks she is a princess. He himself has gone shopping for her clothes. Am I deaf? Tell me. Yeah? I could have gone for shopping, but nobody listens to me. Oh, my God. They just don't respect me. Don't pretend to be the obedient daughter-in-law. Well, your biggest duty is to give us an heir to this family. Did you understand? We want a grandson. But what can you expect from a childless woman like you? Now go away from here.
Dear, how will I live without you?
my dear Bhagwati. Your daughter has not married yet, and you have started crying like this. Your daughter is not leaving you tomorrow. She will be here for next 5 years. Yes.
I know. But what can I do? I'm a mother after all. My heart weeps when I think about farewell.
Don't think like this, my dear. The boy is good, the family is good. Just imagine she will be very happy. Well, they say a perfect life partner is very essential for a girl. Yes.
Hey, look, Jagdish is coming.
What are you guys playing?
What's the matter, Jagdish? Why are you so dressed up? Are you going to see some girl?
Why should I go so far away to see her? I have a photograph.
Show it to us. Let us see how your wife is.
What happened?
She seems older than you. She's gonna dominate you big time. She gets angry with you, she might even beat you up.
Well, Jagdish, it seems your life is ruined.
We will get some gold bangles made for Anandi. They'll look very beautiful with the outfit.
Have a look, Mom. I am thinking of giving this to Jagdish's wife.
So without informing me, you went and bought these ornaments, Sumitra?
Well, no, Mom. My brother gifted me during the festival.
Do you want to spoil our reputation? We have everything with us, and you want to give her something that your brother gifted you. Don't you know people just want a topic to gossip? They will think that we don't have enough money, that is why we have to rely on your brother. Do you want to tarnish this family's reputation? Keep this inside. And tell your brother, in case he needs more ornaments, I will send a box full to his house, okay? Like your brother provides you with everything. Take a look at this. How is it? I have preserved this for a long time for Jagdish's wife.
This seems very expensive.
So Basant, even my grandson is priceless. He is my sole heir. And listen, Jamuna, I expect a son from you also. I have kept one aside for his wife as well. Yeah.
Dad? Dad, is my wife to be going to be older than me?
That will be good. It's better to have an older daughter-in-law. She will bring happiness to this family.
Oh, come on now, stop it. Stop troubling my dear grandson. You come to me. Come here, dear. Oh no, Jagdish. She is not at all older than you. They all are making fun of you.
Really, Grandma?
Oh yes. Why should I lie to you, huh? Go, you play.
Bhagwati, this one will be for Anandi's mom-in-law. And this one for her grandma. She is a proud woman. So it will be a tough to impress her. Otherwise, she will be angry.
Bhagwati, here it is. I have got the other stuff.
Is there something for me?
What? What do you mean?
Even in this, there's nothing for me.
You will get your things afterwards. This is for your dowry. Got it?
What is dowry, Dad?
My sweet child, let me explain it to you. When a girl marries and leaves her place, she takes all this stuff along with her, and this is called dowry. Did you understand? Leave it now. When you will grow up, you yourself will understand it. Now go and get some sleep. Tomorrow there is a ritual. And we have to do the veneration. Now go and get some sleep. Come on.
But then why can't I go to school?
Why don't you understand? Just accept it. You can't go to school.
Please tell me why.
According to our ancestors, after a girl's marriage, she shouldn't go out often. That's why.
But why did they say like that?
Look, dear. How many times I have to explain you this? One who wants to become a doctor studies medicine. One who wants to be a government official studies civil management. One pursues education that helps getting a job. Girls have to take care of the household and family in the future. And that education is only available at home. All these things your school won't teach you. They can't teach you how to cook food and other household activities. Yeah? You can learn this only at home. That's why a school is a waste of time for girls. Got it?
17 ones are 17.
17 ones are 17.
17 twos are 34.
17 twos are 34.
17 threes are 51.
17 threes are 51.
17 fours are 68.
17 fours are 68.
17 fives are 85.
17 fives are 85.
17 sixes are 102.
17 sixes are 102.
Fifteen ones are 15. 15 ones are 15. 15 twos are 30. 15 twos are 35. 15 threes are 45. 15 threes are 45. 15 fours are 60. 15 fours are 60. 15 fives are 75. 15 fives are 75. 75 fours are 68. 74 are 68.